When you first open SketchUp, you're presented with this Welcome to SketchUp screen. Yours is going to look a little different than mine. And if you have any notices over this, like new SketchUp features, you can go ahead and close that notice for now. This is the screen we're looking for, Welcome to SketchUp. If you accidentally close this like this, you can return back to it by going to Help, Welcome to SketchUp. Now, this top area here is going to be my default template. You're not going to have this because this is a custom template. So you may have like simple as your first one. So if it's not in the same order, that's totally fine. And then below that, we have recent files that you can open from this panel. Again, yours are going to look different. What we're looking to do is go to more templates here so that everything looks the same on my screen and your screen. So if you're brand new and you haven't used a template before, this is basically going to be your SketchUp starting point. So this one has a horizon color turned on, a scale figure in it, a gray ground plane. This one is just a white drawing area. So they all kind of have a different starting point. Plus, they all have their own units of measurement. So this is inches, meters, millimeters, centimeters. We are going to start with plan view inches, and then we're going to customize it slightly, creating our own template. And it will land here under my templates. And that's what I have here. This is the one we're going to create. We're just going to change it slightly, but just know that you can change it even more to create your own template so that you have that to start every project from. So we're going to click on plan view inches, and you want to click on the thumbnail and not the heart yet. Just click on the thumbnail picture, and then we are presented with this white drawing space. Yours is going to say untitled. I already have untitled back here. I'm just going to go ahead and grab this one and make it full size here. This is a great starting point for our SketchUp drawing. It's got a nice blank white space to draw on, and it's a top view, which is great for starting in 2D and then quickly moving to perspective, which is what we're going to do throughout this course. The one thing that I don't like about this template is that when I draw any geometry, I'm going to draw this rectangle here. We're looking to draw some faces, like this is going to represent the floor of our model or the walls. And it's hard to tell the difference between the floor and the space behind it, our drawing space. So if you want to see this, you can grab your rectangle tool, it's the letter R, or this icon here. Click release and click release. Now you have a rectangle, and that rectangle has a face. So tap your space bar or your select tool here, and then click on the face that is enclosed by this rectangle. You can see that it's really hard to tell the difference between the space behind it and the face itself. So we're going to change the style and then save that template. To do that, for Mac users, you're going to go to Window, Styles, and then for Windows users, this is going to be in your default tray on the right. So if you hover over, there's going to be a default tab right here. You can click or hover on that and then work your way down to the Styles panel. And this is the window that we see. It's pretty blank. If you are not seeing this in model panel here, you can click on the home icon to see the style that we're currently using, construction documentation style. So instead of using this style, we're going to create our own so that we can use it in our template. Click on this small icon right in the middle of this line of icons here. Click create new style. And you can see it just duplicated this one, construction documentation style 1. And we're just going to double click on this title here and call it working. Enter. And now you can click on this little update icon to lock in those changes. And you can see that we've got working and we've got construction documentation style. So those two titles there. So we're going to change this working style. Let's go to edit to change that. And you're presented with these buttons here. This one changes the edges. This one changes the faces. So let's take a look at the edges. First off, we're going to turn off the profiles. Uncheck that. And you can see that in this thumbnail here of our style, a little clock appears, which means it's a fast style. So while we're working on our drawing, we want our styles to be fast. And that just means that our model won't be laggy. It won't be jittery as we orbit or move throughout our model. We want to look for this green clock. It's okay to have a style without a green clock if you're presenting to a client. Sometimes those take up more space or a little bit more slow, and that's totally fine. But while we're working on it, we want it to be fast. So turn those profiles off and then click update. Now let's look at the faces. So that's going to be the second icon here. And here's where we're seeing that front color. Right now it's white. So click on the thumbnail. And Windows users, your colors panel is going to be a little bit different. And I apologize about that. That is specific to Mac or specific to Windows and not something that SketchUp can really control. So what we are looking for is you may have to use your color wheel or the slider. On a Mac, you can use these little pencils. What we're looking to do is change that front color to a slight gray, just so that we can see the difference between the face here and the background. Again, just make it something that's dark enough so that you can see the difference. You can also use the slider if you just want to have more control over that. All right, I'm happy with that, so I'll close out of this and then click on the update icon here. Again, go back to select and you'll be able to see the difference. This icon is just a white face with a thicker edge here, thicker profile. And then this one is our working that we just created with the green clock, the slightly gray face there, and the profiles are off. So we're just seeing the edge at a normal thickness. So again, that's under edit, and we altered the first two icons here, turned off profiles, and we changed our front color from white to gray. And with any change, make sure that you click on that little update icon here. Now we can close out of the styles panel. For now, we're going to return back to it, but you can just close it. Or Windows users, you can go ahead and minimize that default tray. I'm also going to delete this face here. So with your select tool, you can just hit your space bar or grab this guy and then double click on the face and tap delete. All right, so now we're back to what we started with, basically just a blank drawing space. But now when we draw anything, we'll be able to see it. We'll be able to see those faces, the difference between the background and the face. Now let's go ahead and save this template. Go to File, Save as Template. And then you can name this whatever you'd like. If you want to call it SketchUp QuickStart, your name and a template or gray face, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to call it QuickStart Template. And then choose Save. And now it will open a new file for you and enable that template right away. So again, if we draw a rectangle, it will be slightly gray. If you go back to Help, Welcome to SketchUp, you'll be able to see that Quick Start Template, and under More Templates, My Templates, that's where it is. So I think that I had something checked there. If I go to Save as Template, I had Set as Default Template checked. So it moved that heart icon over to, we'll head back over here. That heart icon is now on Quick Start Template. So if you don't want that there, you can move it to another template, like Simple or whatever you want to use. But that heart basically means anytime you start a new file, that's the starting point. So it may be helpful just for the sake of learning to leave that heart on Quick Start Template so that you start in the same spot as me more often. All right, we are going to dive in the next lesson and start drawing.